Hi, sorry to keep you waiting. Welcome to the world of Pokemon. My name is Birch, but everyone calls me the Pokemon Professor. And this is what we call a Pokemon. Whoa, what the hell? That's different. Whoa. 3D Pokemon. This world is widely inhabited by creatures known as Pokemon. We humans live alongside Pokemon, at times playing together as friends, and at times helping one another out. And sometimes, we just like to have fun battling others like us. Well, but as close as we are, we don't know every- God damn! In fact, there are still many, many mysteries surrounding Pokemon. I do research to try and unravel those Pokemon mysteries, but that's enough about me. Oh my god, that's way too fast. Yeah, I might actually experience some lag. What about you? Are you a boy or are you a girl? I'm a boy. Actually, no. The King Savon. God damn. Yeah. Oh, I see. You're that King Super One. You're the one who's moving to Little Root Town where I live. Are you ready? Your very own adventure is about to unfold. Be courageous and leap into the world of Pokemon with dreams, adventures, and friendship await. I expect we'll be meeting again soon. Oh, god damn. Whoa. 3D. The box is printed with Pokemon logo. It's a Pokemon brand moving and delivery service. It's an Azure doll. It has a familiar smell. Super One, you're here at last. Wasn't it tough riding in the back of the bumpy moving truck all that way? Well, this is Little Root Town. What do you think? This is going to be our new home. It has a quaint feel, but it looks like it should be a nice place to live, don't you think? And you get your own room this time, King Super One. Come on, you have to see the inside. King Super One, isn't it nice in here too? See, Super One, isn't it nice here too? The moving company Pokemon even helped with the compacting and the cleanup. They really make the moving a clinch.
Grr.
Thanks for all the hard work, we really appreciate it.
Grr.
This time they leave instead of staying, going, but walking back and forth. You should go and see your new room upstairs, Super One. Oh, by the way, I forgot. I changed it to Super One because game forgot fucked up. Forgot to save. And yeah. Anyways, Dad even bought a new clock for it to help celebrate the big move. You need to set the time though. Movies on TV. Two men are dancing on a big piano keyboard. Better get going. It's filled with Pokemon magazines. Pokemon Pal, Pokemon Handbook, Adorable Pokemon. Looks like Mom jotted something down. There are notes about tonight's dinner plans. Ooh. It's an Azrael doll. It has a familiar smell. Why is it here? What's with that doll? What do I have? Ooh, I got a Snorlax. Oh, damn. Mom likes this Pokemon. Better get going. Okay. It's a Wii U. It has a gamepad with a screen. Superwoman's notebook is full of adventures he jotted down. Adventure number one, open menu with the X button. Adventure number two, record your progress save. Oh, let's do that right now. Yeah. Yeah. There you go. Done. Alright, we're good. I'm done playing. So, you know. And the best thing about this. Oh, shit. I forgot to go to time. Best thing about the clock on the wall isn't moving. You set the time. It automatically does this. Wow. That's crazy. The hour hand was at the 16, the minute hand is 38. So if anyone was, it's 438. How do you like your new room, Superwoman? Good. Everything's put away neatly. They finished moving everything in downstairs too. It really is so nice having Pokemon around to help us. Oh, but you should make sure that everything's all there on your desk. What do you mean? I'm dying. Oh. There's no Pokemon. Oh, Super One, quick, come quickly. It's the Peterborough Gym. Maybe Dan will be on TV. We brought you this report live from the front of Peterborough Gym. Next up, a special look at a long-awaited meteor shower in the next star show. Oh, it's already ended. Looks like your dad was on, but he missed this part. What a shame. But that reminds me, one of Dan's friends lives in this town. Professor Birch is his name. He lives right next door. Maybe you should go over and introduce yourself. Go. See, and the best thing about it is you can run. I have to sit there and wait. Oh. It's not safe to go out there if you don't have any Pokemon with you. Oh, damn. If you step into the tall grass on the route up ahead, wild Pokemon will jump out at you. Oh, that's right. Think that you can get data from the friends you pass by even when your Nintendo 3DS is in sleep mode. 3DS? The power of science is staggering. Wow. Professor Burst? Oh yeah, this is 3DS. It's... I don't even know, bro. I'm too high to think right now. Professor Burst will spend days in the end of his lab researching something and he will suddenly go out into the field to gather more data. When does he ever spend more time at home? To. Huh? Looking for Professor Birch? Birch away on field work, ergo, not here. Oh, I guess I have to tell you what field work is. Field work's when you study things in their natural environments, like out in the fields and mountains instead of in a laboratory. The professor isn't one for doing desk work, really. He's a type that would rather go outside and experience things and read about them here. He's probably doing a survey of Route 101 now. It's just outside of the town. Alright, damn. Burke's house, let's go. Huh? Oh, hello, and you are? Oh, you're Superwoman, our new next door neighbor, welcome. We have a daughter about the same age as you. She has been so excited about making a new friend. she should be in her room upstairs. Oh, I hope you'll go and introduce yourself. And that's on the kids, not even there. Just one person. Pokemon fully restored, items are ready, and... Oh! Huh? Who are you? Oh, you must be Super One. Your move was today, huh? Well, I'm May, glad to meet you. I actually have this dream of becoming friends with Pokemon all over the world. And then when Professor Birch told me about you moving here, Super One. Well, I'm hoping you would be nice and we could be friends. But that's just silly, isn't it? I just met you, right, Super One? So what I'm talking about, Oh no, I forgot. I was supposed to be out to help Dad catch some wild Pokemon. Super One, I'll see you later. The pretty cute wall clock. There are two notes on the page written cute in round script. This will be on the next test. Each Pokemon can learn up to 4 moves. Which moves you teach Pokemon will show how good of a trainer you are. Okay. Yeah, she don't got anything. Oh yeah, I got a Snorlax. So we use gamepad on the screen. Dad might like this program. Alright. You and your dad. Stuff. What do you have to say? Where's that husband of mine? It was so good for you to visit, Super One. And yet, he's nowhere to be found. There are plans for the whole week worth of meals. Damn. Oh god, no. I'm not doing this. It's too much. Many varieties of that. I'm not trying to do all that. Little Root Town, a town that can't be shaded by any hue. Okay. I think I hear someone screaming up ahead. What should I do? What should we do? Somebody has to go help. Help me! Hello, you over there, please, help me out. Get back, here's some Pokeballs. Oh no. Where are you going? Don't leave like this. Where are you going? Don't leave like this. Where are you going? Don't leave like this. Where are you going? Okay, I'm sorry. So who am I getting? Torchic? Not a good sign. Let's hope it's not super lag. Okay. We're good. Dang, he learns Ember already. I'm gonna get scratched up. Phew. I went to the tall grass to survey wild Pokemon when I was suddenly jumped. You saved my hide. Thanks a lot. Oh, but you're Norman's boy, Super One. I didn't realize who you were at first. You've grown to quite the young man. This isn't the place for a chat, though. Come along to my lab. Thank you. So, Super One, I heard so much about you from your father, but he said that you don't have your own Pokemon yet. If that's true, that was quite the performance back there. Looks like you really are your father's son. Oh yes, just to say thanks for rescuing me out there. How about I give you that Pokemon you used earlier?
Yes, get the torch, yes!
While you're at it, why don't you give it a nickname to that torture? Yep, that's the spirit. So what kind of name will you go with? Uh-oh. You know, if you work with your Pokemon and gain experience, I think you'll make a pretty excellent trainer. My girl Mei happens to be out in Route 103 right now, serving Pokemon for me. It may not be the bad idea for you, but to head out that way yourself. What do you think? Let's go. Great. I'm sure Mei would be happy to hear that too. She'll help teach you what that means to be a trainer. Oh yes. If you ever lost along the way, use the area nav on your PokéNav Plus. You can use it to see how to get to Route 103, where Mei ought to be. And if you and your Pokemon get tired, get some rest back to your new house. Professor Versus Summon Habits and sits and introduces a Pokemon. The professor enjoys Mei's help too. There's a lot of love there. Professor Birch will spend days in the lab researching something, then he'll suddenly go out in the field to gather more data. When does he ever spend time at home? I don't know. Alright, okay, read that already. Alright, what do you have to say? Boy, I'm glad there was an interpret guide like you to rescue the professor. Oh, Mei's not your want. Oh, if Mei's your wanting, she's going off somewhere again. That child is just like her father. She can't stay in the house for 5 minutes. Damn. Okay. Let's get out. Let's go.